Okie dokie, we've wrapped up the smallmouth day. What a beautiful river this is. I'm so glad we chose this one right here to do some fishing. While we wrapped up the smallmouth fishing, I still kind of want to give you guys a little sneak peek of our place, our palace for the night. Every night we've got a new home, a new spot in which we're camping at. This one just so happens to be on a little island right in the middle of Ouichita River. This is so cool. Like, we're surrounded by a stretch river over there, and then over there we've got some more river. It's a nice little situation here. So this is our setup. We're doing yet another meal over just a straight up fire provided by this guy right here. What's on the menu for today?
We're getting the grease ready with the bacon. Oh. We got 12 brats that we're gonna eat every single one of them.
All 12 we're gonna eat. 12. Yeah. So this trip has also all been about conserving food and making sure we have enough for the 7 days. No, but seriously, we get so hungry, we don't eat throughout the day. I know the natural human isn't supposed to eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner. We pretty much eat like a little breakfast in the morning, and then during dinner time, like right about now, is when we just go ham. We just eat like sausages, steaks, you know, the whole nine yards. Lawson, give me an insight as a Florida guy. How did you enjoy these Arkansas rivers?
I would say it's just a completely different landscape. So even if, like, I mean, you can say, you've said it before to me, you'd rather be here in the river catching 2 pound smallmouth than out in a giant lake catching 6 pound smallmouth, because it's about the adventure and the location.
Oh, totally. Like in the water, right?
Yeah.
You're legitimately bringing the fight to them.
I've never seen anything like this in my life. Growing up in Florida, you won't even get a hill this big as this freaking 2-inch incline over here in Florida. And I was saying to John earlier too, it's surreal wading in the water and just chilling out and not being worried, because where I'm from, if you're wading fresh water, you gotta watch out for alligators. Wading salt water, you gotta watch out for sharks. Here, it's just fish.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's a good point. It's like you're very chill. Like, you're not on your guard when you're out here in Arkansas. The only thing you really have to worry about is, I think, cottonmouths, and that's pretty much it. Maybe a snap control too. But as far as things that can kill you and are lethal, there is a very short list. Please, though, watch out for vicious wiener dogs. They run rabid around here, and they are not harmless. So food and fire over there. Over here, we've got where we're sleeping. We brought the big cooler with us, a little bit unnecessary, something I wouldn't suggest if you're gonna especially do a big canoe float, because it adds a ton of weight to your operation, but it is nice to have if you've got food. This is essentially what I pack with me when I'm going on a float like this. I'll bring a knife, one of these little life straws. It's nice to have in case your water supply runs out for some weird reason, like if I pump a hole in my water bottle. Got a Camelback, which my girlfriend gave me. Shout out to you. Thanks, appreciate it. Then of course I got the fishing essentials, which isn't really survival necessary, but got some Guggen baits, drag and drops, and Slim Shakes. Got this little doohickey here. It's called a BioLite. It's gonna help me if we can't find like appropriate firewood, or if we're just kind of SOL and need to start a quick fire. This thing is super key. I'll do a review on this later, but for the most part, you get the idea. I got my sleeping mattress, which isn't a necessity, but I like it because, as you can see, we're sleeping on just straight rock, and this is not super comfortable. Over here, I have my little light. It's good to have at night. This thing is super, super bright. I don't know how many lumens this is, but it's up there. I've got a rope just in case we need to tie off the canoes or something like that. It's just nice to have a rope for many different reasons. In here, I've got my car keys with a compass. Also, this seems pretty archaic, but it's something good to have. Even though we've got so many ways of making fire, like a lighter and this little BioLite thing, I always carry a pack of waterproof matches with me wherever I go, especially if I'm on the water. It's just really nice to have. If your lighter's not working, if you just can't seem to get a fire because there's wet wood and nothing seems to be working, this will save your life. Completely waterproof. I got some wipes. Again, not a necessity, but I like to keep them with just because I haven't showered in about 3.5 days and I'm pretty stinky. And then of course, here's our tent. This is the tent. It's a 4-person Coleman. I would say it's more of a 2-person. It's not that big. What's nice about this tent is it pops up like within like 60 seconds. It's not like your traditional tent. It's a lazy guy's tent, but it's nice when you're doing a lot of other things like fishing and traveling. And the last thing you want to do is set up a freaking tent. So it's very convenient in that sense. Yeah, it's not ginormous in here, but it gets the job done. Also, I like how these beams allow me to hang clothes that get wet on them too. Very key. Very, very key. Also, we have a 30-liter dry bag. This is very essential if you're doing a water trip. We also bring a wiener dog wherever we go. She doesn't come in handy too much other than just moral support. You're a great happy dog that just likes to tag along. That's it, you guys got the lay of the land. You got to see our campsite for the night. It's gonna change every single night, but this is the operation we've got. It's the thing is, it varies. So usually throughout this trip, we're gonna have the rig runner with us. We camp out of the rig runner and we set the tent nearby, but we obviously can't bring the rig runner out on the river, so we had to adjust, pack light because we're in the canoes. And as you can see, our setup varies every single day. But that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I appreciate it. Love y'all so much. I'm signing out. We're gonna eat some beautiful bacon. As always, folks, keep fishing. Never stop. Oh, okay, okay. Hold on. Before we close this video out right now, I gotta mention something that I failed to mention when I filmed this video. Let's just do a quick fast forward. Right now, I'm currently in Alaska about to embark on yet another journey. It just so happens that I'm wrapping this video up in the midst of another expedition, at least the beginning of. Anyway, let's cut to the chase. That chase being something I wish I would have said in this video. Pack with a purpose. And what I mean by pack with a purpose is bring things that will genuinely help you. I think a lot of people get surviving and camping mixed up. We weren't surviving, we were camping. But at the same time, I think there's a happy middle in between both. I think it's appropriate to pack to help solve a problem out in the wilderness while also not going overboard. You know, you don't need to pack a flare gun, walkie-talkie, your GPS, and like 30 means of starting a fire if you're gonna do a 2 to 3 day float out in Arkansas. What I'm trying to say is that we probably shouldn't have brought the cooler. We probably shouldn't have brought some of these things. And looking back, I wish I would have left some things behind and found a better alternative. But the main purpose of this video is just to show you guys our setup. Not saying our setup was ideal or 100% right, or that you should follow our setup when going out on a creek float mission or something like that. But it's just something to keep in mind. Wow, Alaska, you are really loud right now. Give it a second. My buddy Lawson and I are about to hop on a helicopter to Bristol Bay, Alaska. Before we do that, I've been trying to do as much homework as I possibly can. I'm reading this book called Bushcraft 101. I hate reading, I really do. But you know what? I think reading is good, especially if you're gonna go into something quite blindly. So I'm reading this book right now, I'm getting some good information, and I wanted to read a little tiny sentence, a short paragraph from this book that I thought was pretty interesting and could apply to any of your situations. Whether you guys go out and do a little fishing camping trip, and I think this is very important to just know before you embark on a big old journey, or a little journey like the one we just did in Arkansas. Wise hikers carry few essentials and tools with them on their journey. Instead of extra equipment, they carry the knowledge and skills needed to create necessary items straight from the landscape. Pretty interesting. Yes, that kind of veers more towards the survival aspect of going out in the woods. It still is something to kind of keep in mind, you know? You guys saw all the stuff we had. We were pretty much prepared for the worst, but we jump in that canoe, tip over, hit some really nasty rapids, and we lose all of our stuff, and we are basically back to square one. We have nothing but the clothes on our back. Go out there, enjoy yourself, pack for all the comforts, you know, bring a cooler, bring a fan, have some food, bring 30 brats, whatever you want to freaking do, but have a plan B, C, D, and etc. If you are confident in yourself, dude, these airplanes are being just today. I can't even talk in front of the camera. Welcome to Alaska, we're right by the hangar, I guess. Bring everything that you want, okay? But be prepared for when that stuff could possibly be gone. That's my little message. I just wanted to kind of wrap today's video up with that little tiny piece of info, but this is pretty much gonna be the last video from me. Hopefully you guys will see some more videos. I kind of am handing off the channel to Bryant, you know, BR Pat, but yeah, he's gonna freaking edit some stuff while I am doing some fishing and exploring and hiking and bear avoiding. Did I mention I'm really afraid of bears and there's like lots of Kodiaks around here? Anyway, let's just not think about that. I'm a little nervous, as you can tell. That's it, I'm signing out. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. As always, folks, keep fishing, keep exploring, never stop.